Happy New Year. Happy New Year, ELA. We're back. Welcome back. All right, so we're back, and we're going to do Paul Revere. It's a great story. We're going to read it tomorrow. We're kind of going to get ready for it today. A little preview, some vocabulary words, some reading to do, things like that. All right, so it'll just be a few quick little reading of books and a little worksheet, and then we'll get on with the real stuff, all right? All right, so let's do this, and then what happened, Paul Revere?
Voices of the Revolution.
All right, so it's Voices of the Revolution, kind of what we're studying in history. But it's not history. It's supposed to be L.A., Mr. Gately. I know. We're reading a lot of nonfiction and some historical fiction in ELA class about the American Revolution.
We had always had governed ourselves, and we always meant to. Farmer at the Battle of Lexington, April 1775.
The flame is kindled, and like lightning it catches from soul to soul.
Abigail Adams.
I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty, or give me death.
Patrick Henry.
Voices of the Revolution with Walter Dean Myers. Dear reader, the American Revolution created a new country, the United States of America. It also created a fascinating set of symbols that we have learned to love and that represents our country and values. The Declaration of Independence. The Declaration of Independence is the document that announced to the world that the United States is a free nation. The day it was adopted, the 4th of July, became a day symbolizing freedom and the nation's birthday. Hope we know that. We've been studying it and are going to this week. The first American flag. The 13 stripes of the first American flag represent the 13 colonies that had broken away from England. The colonies formed a new constellation, represented by the 13 white stars. The Great Seal of the United States. We carry an image of the Great Seal in our wallets on the $1 bill. On the front of the seal, a bald eagle holds the arrows of war. In one talon, an olive branch of peace in the other. In its beak, there is a ribbon bearing the motto, E pluribus unum, out of many, one. The bald eagle. In 1782, the American bald eagle became our national emblem. The eagle was chosen for its long life, great strength, and majestic appearance. Benjamin Franklin, however, did not like the bald eagle. He preferred to have the wild turkey as our national bird. The Liberty Bell. The Liberty Bell was made in 1753 and was used to signal important events. It rang on July 8, 1776. When the Declaration of Independence was first read. The bell weighs 2,080 pounds. Over a ton. During the difficult days of the Revolutionary War, a war in which the colonists often found that they had to live under the hostile eyes of the British Army, the symbols of the new country brought comfort and inspiration. For me, the stars and stripes of the American flag, the American bald eagle, and the Declaration of Independence have always been stirring symbols of what makes me proud to be an American. Walter Dean Myers.
on the brink of war.
Between 1765 and 1770, people in the 13 American colonies grew tired of being ruled by England. When the English king ordered more taxes, the colonies found ways to oppose him. And then what happened, Paul Revere, shows how one American patriot helped begin a revolution to end English rule. The colonists showed the hatred of unfair taxes wherever possible, even on teapots. King George III sent soldiers to make colonists obey his laws. In protest, Paul Revere created this picture of English ships arriving in Boston Harbor in 1768. New England farmers prepared to fight the British on a moment's notice. That moment arrived on April 19, 1775, when the first shots of the American Revolution were fired in Lexington, Massachusetts. The patriots came from many backgrounds and professions. Paul Revere, shown in this portrait by John Sicklin Copley, was a silversmith and an express rider, spreading news of patriots and British activities. Okay, so those are just some of the vocabulary words and big symbols of America. So hopefully, when you do the sheet, hopefully by knowing these words, you'll be more prepared to read. And then what happened, Paul Revere?